What is up, disc golfers? Today on Iceberg TV, I'm really excited to bring you my review of the Paul McBeth Discraft Malta. So when I had this thing in my hands at first, I thought it felt somewhere between like a Rock 3 and a Gator, and I'm finding that the flight is somewhere in between them as well. So the Paul McBeth Malta is a 5-4-1-3. So what you should see out of this disc is a slight turn and a really hard fade, especially when thrown flat. So first and foremost, I don't think this disc really flies like the flight numbers would indicate. And I actually found it like to be fairly unpredictable, and I honestly don't think Paul's gonna be bagging these anytime soon. I actually don't really love this disc. So when I found that I was throwing it hard and flat, it would turn over and just ride the turn all the way to the ground. But if I threw it on any amount of hyzer, it'll just hyzer out super hard, super quickly. And if you throw it like soft and flat, it'll just like, I mean, fly like any disc when you throw it soft and flat, and it'll just like go straight for a little bit and then burn into the ground. And it finds itself somewhere between like a mid-range and an approach disc. And I just think it's not extreme enough in either direction to really have a specific use, at least in my bag. So I want to compare it to a couple of other discs. So we sort of have the, it's pretty obvious that I have a Paul McBeth Rock 3 here, and I think it's pretty safe to say that like they tried to make the Rock 3. It's pretty obvious that these discs are like pretty much the exact same in every single way. But for some reason, these Rocks just have more glide and they're straighter. And then this is like glidey and unpredictable when you throw it flat, and then like super dumpy, overstable when you throw it on hyzer. And I originally thought it was more like a Gator, but it's not as blunt on the edge as a Gator. So if we compare the Gator to this, you can see that the Gator's a lot flatter, especially on the rim. And the Gator is gonna give you that predictable sort of, whether you throw it flat or on hyzer, on anhyzer, it's gonna work out of it and crash to the ground. Because it's blunt, it probably won't skip. This disc tends to get a lot more ground action, especially because you feel like you have to throw it hard to get the proper flight out of it. And I just don't see this replacing Paul's Buzz. With all this being said, it really just feels like the Discraft Malta, it was Discraft's attempt at replicating the Rock 3. And I'm sure Paul has some prototypes or some test runs that flew like the Rock 3, or he wouldn't have had them make this. But when the stock run came out, Paul literally said in one of his videos, he was like, yeah, I wish these came out a little bit flatter and more overstable like the prototypes did. So this is one of the prototypes, and it's not super flat, but it is pretty flat compared to the rest of the Maltas. The rest of the Maltas are domier and a little bit glidier, which will probably make them a little bit more user-friendly to newer players. But the prototype Malta isn't really the most user-friendly disc, and I found it to be fairly unpredictable. Again, like I said, when I throw it flat and hard, it wants to like get over and then not fade out at all. But then when I throw it on any amount of hyzer, just, I mean, it just gets over so quick and so hard left. I found myself trying to aim at the basket or aim in the direction of my line, and I was either turning it over and it wouldn't come out, or just hyzer out. So either of those scenarios, it's the disc wasn't really going in the direction that I wanted it to go in. Obviously, it's a reliable hyzer disc, but like 90% of discs are reliable hyzer discs. You want to just get something that feels comfortable in your hand. So my thoughts on the Maltas, I'm not super impressed. I really didn't like this disc that much. Absolutely love the Onyx, so they did a really good job on the Onyx, but it looks like they just made like a worse version of the Innova Rock 3. And I tested this on forehand lines as well, and this disc doesn't handle, if you have torquey throws or a torquey forehand or backhand, you're gonna turn it over as well, and it's not gonna be consistent for you. I have a fairly smooth forehand, and even on hyzer throws, it would pick up and sometimes ride to the left, and then if it didn't do that, it would just pick up and go straight, which it wasn't dependable on that three fade like I want it to be either. Yeah, I really wanted to like this disc, and I was gonna review this one first, but I just needed to continue testing it so I could form an opinion to give you guys. And when I test a new disc, I really want to find the uses for it, and I really want to like it. But I just don't see this disc replacing like having a zone in your bag and having a buzz in your bag. You're not gonna need this, and Paul's probably not gonna need this either. I think the stock run being a little domier might be a little more user-friendly to newer players, but especially this prototype run, like I really just I'm not a big fan of this disc, and it's definitely not gonna make my bag, unfortunately. It's a really nice disc, and it's a really cool disc, but I just don't love it. One huge shout out to the patrons. Thank you so much for donating to the channel. If you wanna get some Iceberg TV merch, click the link in the description below. If you wanna become a patron, click the link in the description below as well. Thank you for watching. This is Iceberg TV, and take care.